بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I want to remind myself and everyone the importance of following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is the final messenger sent to humanity, and he came with the Quran. He left his legacy. What legacy will you leave behind? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his greatest legacy was the Quran and the Sunnah. Whenever he taught the Quran to the Sahaba, it was about transformation. It was about changing. It was taking the words of Allah Azza wa Jal and translating that theory, that knowledge, that iman into action. Many of the scholars, they say, لَيْسَ الْإِيمَانِ بِتَحَلِّي وَلَا بِتَمَنِّي. They say faith, iman, is not tahalli. It's not the things that you adorn yourself with. It's not the outer appearance alone. Nor is it bitamanni, you know, this wishful thinking. One day I will change. One day I wish to memorize Quran. One day I wish to wear the hijab. One day I'll listen to my parents. One day I'll fix up and establish my prayers. ولكن الإيمان ما وقر في القلب وصدقت الأعمال. But rather, true iman, faith, is what settles in the heart and it is affirmed through action. So when we stand before Allah Azza wa Jal, know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the way to celebrate and follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to live by his example. He is uswatun hasana. He is our role model. Whenever we look at these great celebrities and these famous people and so on, there is something, there's a reason why you follow them. There's a reason why you know about their life. Know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is guiding us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't attach the hearts of the creation to himself, but he attached the hearts of the creation to the Creator Al-Khaliq. And this is his message. This is his legacy. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he led by example. He was a servant leader. He was loved by everyone. He was honored. He was respected. Some people did not like his message because he called to the oneness of Allah Azza wa Jal. He said that this life that we live is limited and that the life that you have should be only lived for Allah and Allah alone. So in your life, are you living for Allah? What are you doing with your days and nights? Why do you pursue whatever you're pursuing in life? Where are you headed? What are you pursuing and what legacy will you leave behind? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he left the Quran and the Sunnah. The Quran is the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is the speech of Allah. And whoever holds on to the speech of Allah will find happiness, will find joy, will find comfort, will find relief, anxiety is expelled. All of these blessings come along. And holding on to the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our light, is our guidance in this dunya. In this dunya, we are lost. We are in the state of worry, in the state of anxiety, not knowing what am I living for? What is my purpose in this dunya? What will happen in the grave? What will happen when I stand before Allah Azza wa Jal? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explains that and more through his teachings, through his dealings. How was he with the old? How was he with the young? How was he with the enemies of Allah? His neighbors, his guests, all of this, his wives, his children, can be found through the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So how do we follow his example? Ittiba'u an-nabi, by following his example, by doing what he did, the actions that he came with, both the fard, the compulsory, and the sunan. Imagine a leader, once he's led the ummah in public, what would he do in private? This is the reality. If you really want to know who I am, ask my wife, my mom, my dad, my brothers and sisters, and my children. Ask them, because in the privacy, in the privacy of one's home, the reality comes out. What was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam known to be doing in the darkest of nights? Late night, what would he be doing? Aisha radiallahu anha would wake up and she would move her hand and touch the best feet of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he's standing in Qiyamul Layl. He's praying to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Who is watching him? Is there any of the companions there? Is there an audience? Is there YouTube? Is there people on Instagram? Is anyone watching him? Does he have followers, people seeing him? No. In the darkest of nights, in his room, he's standing before Allah Azza wa Jal. And he's praying Qiyamul Layl. He finds pleasure in standing in Qiyamul Layl. Many of us, we stand, but we stand for wrong reasons. We can persevere and go through pain, but maybe there is no reward in it. Maybe there's something that you enjoy doing or watching, and it takes you 2 hours or 3 hours just to travel to work and forth. You know what you're seeking and you know the pleasure that comes after it. He is standing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Qiyamul Layl. And when he finishes, his wife asks him, our mother, the mother of the believers, Aisha radiallahu anha, why are you doing this? He said, should I not be a grateful servant? So here we learn that all success lies in when you show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, going above and beyond for Allah azza wa jal. Why? It is Allah who gave you life, sight, ability to talk, your family, whatever you have in your life, and most importantly, your Islam was given to you by Allah azza wa jal. But that did not stop the Prophet. He is ar-Rasul, the last of messengers. Yet he didn't hesitate in worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal in the privacy of his own home. Many of the scholars have said, if you rectify your hereafter, Allah will rectify your dunya. And if you rectify your privacy, when no one can see you, Allah will rectify your public. So my message to everyone, including myself, is really live the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our love of Rasulullah is not limited to, or should not only be, an expression on our tongue, wearing a wristband that says, I love the Rasul, or dancing and singing like some people do of I love Rasul. No, but the true example of loving the Rasul is following his example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.